the challenge trial market remains strong. From 24 to 25, I know there's been some slowness, but basically it's a delay of a single contract that has caused that slowness. And now with these new signings we're getting, we will see an uptick again.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is hVIVO Chief Executive Mo Khan. Mo, more exciting news for hVIVO this morning. You've announced a new human challenge trial contract with Inhalon Pharma. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, so thank you, Stephen. Seeing a lot of you lately. I'm very pleased to speak to you again so soon. So yes, yeah, so we've signed this a significant contract for an RSV antiviral human challenge trial with a company called Inhalon, a biotech company based in the US. We've been talking to them for a while, actually, trying to determine what kind of study they want to run, when they want to run it, and things like that. And we've come to an agreement on the study design. It's going to be three different arms, so it's going to be a good size of a study, and also show that the human challenge trials can do more than just determine whether a drug works or not. So that's great news for this. The study will start in the second half of 2026, and that's when we expect to recognize the majority of revenue from this contract. So excellent news. Great to have Inhalon as a client, and we want to do everything we can to help them propagate the development of this exciting inhaled antibody for them.
Inhalon's drug candidate is a mucosal RSV antiviral. What does that mean, Mo?
Yeah, so I think the key thing here in any kind of infection is the route of administration. So I don't know whether you're aware a lot about RSV. So young, healthy people like you and me, for example, we probably have had RSV infection and we don't even know about it because our immune system fights against it and you don't feel the symptoms. But if you're a young infant or elderly or immunocompromised, it can be a fairly debilitating disease. And what we, what Inhalon wants to do is basically ease the route of administration for these patients. Because imagine trying to inject a young infant with an antiviral. It's not the greatest experience. So what they've done is they've developed this platform where they basically use an inhaled administration to trap the pathogen on the mucosal lining. So effectively, it means that it stops the virus from getting into the lungs. And once in the mucosal lining and it's trapped, it can be excreted quite easily. And just the consequences are quite significant. So if you imagine going back to the pandemic, if we had an inhaled vaccine at that point, for example, you would not need to have a lockdown, because one of the key advantages of having an oral or inhaled vaccine or antiviral, it reduces transmission as well. So this is really kind of the next stage of development for vaccines and antivirals. I mean, the goal ultimately will be, you know, you have an oral tablet or liquid that you take to treat these type of infections. And with this technology, in the future, if it works, of course, it's great, because not only does it work for RSV, you can use the same platform for other pathogens. So, for example, para influenza, for HMPV, for coronaviruses. So let's see how this one goes. And if it's positive, then, you know, potentially Inhalon may be back for more challenge drugs.
I know that some speculated that after approval of the RSV vaccines last year, that there would be a slowdown in your RSV work. This doesn't seem to be the case, though. You mentioned previously that RSV antivirals are a key growth area for hVIVO's core HCT business, Mo. What are some of the other drivers?
No, we don't agree with that point of view, right? So just because there's a couple of or three vaccines now for RSV in the market, it doesn't mean that the R&D for an RSV suddenly stops. There's always goals to continue to improve RSV vaccine in the first instance, you know, to get vaccines that have easier routes of administration, that have longer durability. I think that will keep going. And as the virus evolves, I'm sure we will need to update those vaccines. But on the antiviral side, I mean, that's crucial that the people who need those antiviral treatment therapeutics for this infection, that they get it. And at the moment, there's not really one RSV antiviral that is available that focuses on the kind of severe impacts of RSV. So yeah, I think going forward, we expect to see more RSV work. I mean, we signed a large contract late last year, for an RSV antiviral. This, in addition to that, I mean, we've invested in updating our portfolio of RSV challenge models, and we wouldn't have done that unless we believe that there is a mid to long-term market in this research.
So, lots of growth ahead. This is your fourth new study to be announced in under 2 months. Does this mean you're seeing an increase in conversion of your sales pipeline into signed contracts?
Oh yes, I mean, that's a fact now, right? If you looked at the second half of 2024, we saw a slowness in regards to signatures, although the number of queries we had coming in and interest in human challenge trials remained strong and robust, the number of signings did reduce. And there was a number of reasons for that. The general market was suppressed. I think the US elections also caused a little bit of uncertainty. So the biotech and pharma company weren't making as many decisions. But just in the last, what, 4 to 6 weeks, I think, we've signed a good number of contracts. So yeah, it's no longer my opinion that things have improved. I think with the signatures we have recently announced, I think that that's proof that the market is turning around. And I think one of the key things I do want to say to you and to your audience is that the challenge trial market remains strong. From 24 to 25, I know there's been some slowness, but basically it's a delay of a single contract that has caused that slowness. And now with these new signings we're getting, we will see an uptick again.
A quick note on CRS. It's been just a few days since the acquisition. How are things progressing?
Yeah, so we completed the acquisition this week. As you know, I think I spoke to you about that already earlier this week. Progressing really well. So we've had a town hall call internally for with the hVIVO team. We also had a town hall call for the CRS team, and everyone seems to be very excited and willing to collaborate. We already have some new opportunities where we're adding Ven and hVIVO services to CRS services to offer a more fuller service to the clients of CRS. So no, I'm super excited. The team, both hVIVO and CRS, it's super excited. You know, we've spoken to the CRS team about the different areas where we will invest, where we will implement the systems, and they're very eager to bring them on board. So yes, so far so good.
Well, it looks like a very busy year ahead for the company. I'm sure you're going to be having lots of conversations.
I will. Thank you very much.
Thanks for joining us today. Mo Khan, Chief Executive of hVIVO.